Well, hello. I feel like I'm the host of a talk show when I have this mirror behind me, but I'm just trying new filming setup, so let me know if this is distracting, but hopefully it'll add some interest to my background. Anyways, welcome back to the Bliss Bean. Today's video is gonna be on how I'm doing digital planning using TeuxDeux. Every time I mention this, I have to explain that it is not spelled TeuxDeux, it is spelled T-E-U-X-D-E-U-X. Now that we've got that cleared up, let's roll the intro. So I started doing digital planning recently because I grew a little frustrated with how difficult it was to manage a paper planner, especially with how many different things I was juggling and how many tasks I had to keep track of. For the longest time, I couldn't find any digital planning tool that worked for me, but then I was watching Rowena Tsai's YouTube channel and she mentioned TeuxDeux, and it just looked perfect because it looked a lot like what I did in my paper planner, just digitized. So I decided to go ahead and try it and I actually ended up loving it. So I wanted to take you guys through how I use TeuxDeux to plan out my weeks and stay organized and on track with my goals. I need to stop talking with my hands. Okay. Let's continue. So first I'm gonna take you guys through some of the like initial setup that I do. So TeuxDeux has a very simple like column-based style. While that might not work for everyone, some people like having a lot of different like scheduling and labeling features, but for me that simplicity works really well. So one of the things that you can do is you can create headers. If you type in a task and you add a hashtag before it, it'll format it as a header, which just means that it'll be bold with a little bit of like a gray background behind it. So I create headers to break up my days. Right now, what I have is a header for lunch, a header for after school, and then another school one is my independent study header, which I use to plan out what I want to get done in that free hour that I have. So by typing in every day or every week after your task, you can make that task repeat. So what I've done, for example, with the lunch header is I just typed in hashtag lunch in all caps and then every day. And then every day I don't have to worry about adding in the lunch header, it's just already there. Another thing I do to set up my planner is repeating tasks. So there are some things that I do every day or every week and I don't want to have to remember to put them into my planner every single time. So for example, daily blog tasks I do every day, obviously. And so I just type in daily blog tasks every day. And then TeuxDeux automatically makes that task appear in my to-do list every single day. There are also some things I do weekly. So for example, weekly planning. So when I first started using TeuxDeux, I put in plan next week every week and I put that on a Sunday. So now every Sunday that task automatically appears in my to-do list. Okay, so that's basically like the foundation setup that I have for my digital planner. The next step is to actually use it to plan my individual weeks. So when I do my weekly planning, which I have a video on, my process is basically the same as it was when I did paper planning. So with my paper planner, I used to like format events differently so that I could tell what was a to-do and what was a timed event. I love that this app can kind of mimic that using headers. So I go into my Google Calendar and then I transfer events from that into TeuxDeux. I just type, for example, hashtag TurboKick at 7 and then it puts that in bold letters and I know that it's an event. This is really, really helpful because then I can like arrange tasks around my events. So I like to set little goals for what I want to get done before I have to go somewhere. I think it just adds like a good sense of urgency that makes you work faster. So I can just drag and drop my tasks and figure out what I want to try and get done before I have to go somewhere. So once all of my events are in, then I figure out what I actually have to do that week. This is the bread and butter of your weekly planning routine. So I still do a brain dump on paper just like I always used to. I write down anything and everything that I might have to do that week. I might decide not to do it later on, but I'm just brain dumping so I'm not trying to filter. Once I've got a list of what I need to do that week, then I take it and I start typing it into TeuxDeux. I don't have to think about when I'm scheduling it as much as I had to when I did paper planning, because I know that if I decide, actually I want to do this on Wednesday instead of Monday, it's super easy to just drag it and move it instead of having to white out and then rewrite it somewhere else. So once all of my tasks are in, it looks pretty overwhelming, but it is nice to just have everything organized and see exactly what you have to do in the upcoming week. The last few steps of my weekly planning routine are to write down 3 or 4 reminders for the week and then 3 things that I'm excited about in the upcoming week. So I used to do that like at the bottom of planner pages or on little post-it notes, but now what I do is I use the lists that TeuxDeux has at the bottom. Basically, you can create any kind of list that you want and you can just see them at the bottom of your screen below your weekly layout. So I've created separate lists for reminders and things I'm excited for. So every week I just clear the things that were in there before and I type in whatever I've decided on for that week. I also want to go over how else I use that list feature because it's super helpful. I have a shopping list. Everyone should have a shopping list. I also have a list of communications to make. So that's basically just people that I need to call or email. It's more productive to just get all of your communications done in one go. So if I have some time, I'll just look at that list and make a bunch of phone calls and send a bunch of emails. The next list is called Do Sometime, which is just things that I don't need to urgently do, but I want to do someday. So I keep track of them there, but the list is starting to get really long, so I might move them into its own separate document. But it's still a nice way to like remember ideas you might have had that you don't want to lose, but you also don't have time to currently work on. The last list is called Systems Check, because lately I've been doing like a little bi-weekly routine where I basically take a look at what routines and habits I have and just try and figure out what's working, what isn't, and what changes I can make to improve. So throughout the week, if I come up with anything I want to take a look at when I'm doing my systems review or systems check, whatever you want to call it, I just put that in that list and I don't have to think about it until Sunday when I actually sit down to do it. Okay, next is how daily planning works with TeuxDeux. So during my morning routine, one of the things that I do is I set 3 priorities for what I want to get done that day. An awesome way to do that with TeuxDeux is by making those tasks bold. Basically how you do that is you just put double asterisks around the task. Asterisk, a very difficult word to say. So even though there's not a lot of customization features in TeuxDeux, like you can't make things different colors, I think the bolding feature really helps to just make a couple of your items stand out. Once I've got 3 priorities set, then I look at all of my tasks and I try to rearrange them in the order that I think I'll do them, and I also try to schedule them around my events. I try to make sure that the priorities I decided on are as early in the day as possible to make sure that they get done. Sometimes that's possible, sometimes it's not, but it's just a good thing to keep in mind that you don't want to leave your priorities for the end of the day. They might never get done. As I go through my day, I just check off whichever tasks I completed. TeuxDeux does have an app, so it's not as easy to use as the computer version, but I do like to have it with me so that I can cross off things I've completed. I will say that it's not as satisfying as filling in a checkbox on a piece of paper, but it's still pretty satisfying. So yeah, that's basically it. That's how I've been using TeuxDeux to plan my life digitally. I've just been really, really enjoying digital planning because it's so nimble. Like, if your plans change somehow, it's so easy to adjust because you literally just drag and drop things around. It's also a lot easier to carry around with you because even though my paper planner was pretty small and light, it's still a hassle to have to find a place to store it, to have to take it out and flip to the right page, find a pen. Your phone, on the other hand, you basically have it with you all the time, so your planner is with you all the time. And I feel like that convenience is just priceless. Another thing that I really like about this is that if I find out about something that I have to do way in the future, or even just like a month in advance, with my paper planner, I made pages as I went, so I wouldn't have the pages for that month yet. So that meant I would have to find another place to write it down, which just got kind of messy. So with TeuxDeux, you can just go to whatever day, however far out in the future it may be, and you can add a task, and then you don't have to worry about it anymore. So there's just a lot of things that make digital planning so convenient. I know that some people will still prefer paper planning, I totally get that, but I encourage you to try out TeuxDeux because for me, it was the thing that converted me. It does cost money, and it costs $3 per month or $2 per month if you buy a yearly subscription, which I think is a totally reasonable price and a worthy investment if it works for you. I'm pretty sure there's like a 1 month free trial, so you can figure out if it works for you. So yeah, that's TeuxDeux for you. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please like and subscribe. I would really, really appreciate it. I look forward to making more videos like this in the future about planning and productivity and things like that. So if you want to make sure you see those, you should subscribe. I'll see you next time. Bye.